Uncle Buki Gets Wee Eye. One day, Uncle Buki made a trip down to the city of Port-au-Prince, and while he was in the big old marketplace, he wandered around and looked at all the wonderful things they didn't have up in the Red Mountains. There were beautiful clay bottles from the north, fine white salt and smooth good soap, fat burras from the plains, cane chairs from Arkahay, and good strong goat skins for drums. Buki just lounged around and enjoyed himself looking. But he had walked so far and so long to get to the city that he became hungrier and hungrier. The smell of fish wafted gently into his nose. "Either I have a pain or I'm hungry," he said to himself. And he began to look around for something to eat. He bought a cassava cake for a penny. And after he had finished it and stood there grinning and wondering what else he should eat, he saw an old man sitting on his haunches munching on something delectable out of a gourd dish. Buki just couldn't help staring at him. He knew it wasn't polite to watch so closely, but every time the old man scooped up some food with two fingers and put it in his mouth and chewed, Buki chewed too. When the old man stopped chewing and dipped his fingers again, Buki opened his mouth in anticipation. And when the old man licked the food off of his fingers and chewed again, Buki chewed with him. He pushed his neck out and leaned forward to sniff. Whatever it was the old man was eating, it was wonderful. Buki knew he must have a dish of it. So he grinned very wide and tipped his hat nicely and said a polite good day. The old man nodded at him and kept on eating. "Pardon me," Buki said, "but where can I get some of that elegant dish?" The old man just shook his head and said nothing. "It smells beautiful, and I've walked all the way from the Red Mountains, and I'd certainly like to know where to buy some." But the old man was deaf, and he didn't hear a word Buki said, so he simply kept on eating. "Or at least what you call it," Buki said. The old man grunted and scooped some on his fingers and licked it off. "Up in the mountains, we consider it very impolite not to answer a question," Buki said a little irritably. The old man looked at Buki and nodded, and Buki nodded back. But the old man said nothing, and Buki lost his patience. "You're certainly the most unaccommodating old Haitian I ever met. A man politely asks you what you're eating, and you won't tell." Precisely at that moment, the old man bit into a big hot red pepper, and his tongue burned like fire. "Wee I," he shouted, "I." Buki beamed. "Woy, what a fine name," he said. "I'm much obliged." And he left the old man and began to look for some wee I. He went to where an old woman was selling fried pistachios and something out of a steaming pot. "Pardon me," Buki said, "but do you have any wee eye?" The woman put her hand over her face to keep from laughing, and she shook her head. Buki tugged at his whiskers. "The people are mighty strange around here," he said to himself. "They certainly make it hard to get a little wee eye." He walked all over the market, and he found roasted peanuts, cornmeal, and dukunu, but none of that wee eye. So finally he ate another cassava cake, but it was a big disappointment to him. That night he went home, and all the way up the mountain trail he kept thinking about the smell that came out of the old man's gourd dish. The next morning he said to Madame Buki, "Why don't we ever have any wee eye like the people in the city?" "Wee eye? I never heard of it," Madame Buki said. "But if you can find it, I can cook it." "Good. If a little old man in the city can eat a little dish of wee eye, I guess I can eat twice as much." So he sent Jean Buki to the Léogane market, but Jean didn't find any wee eye there. He sent him to Sahira, but there wasn't any wee eye there. He sent him to Grand Gouave, but there wasn't any there. Buki was getting angry and impatient. 3 days now without any wee-eye," he complained. "What a stupid boy." So he sent Jean to mourn Campan, and to mourn Mardi Gras, and to grow mourn, but Jean didn't find any wee-eye anyplace. Jean was getting tired of going up and down the trails all day long, from one market to another, and of asking for something that always made everyone laugh, and that nobody had. What ignorance! He can't even go to market and buy a little wee-eye. I'm ashamed to be seen on the road. People must gossip all day long about my stupid family. Then he sent Jean to Tigouave, and Lacou, and Miraguan, but no wee-eye. Jean was getting so that if people said good day to him, he would say wee-eye back. Finally, he told Timalise that he just didn't know where else to look for wee-eye for Buki. Malise sat down to think. He thought for a long time, and then he said, "Leave it to me. I'll get Buki some wee-eye." The next morning, Malise went down in the plain to get some cactus leaves. He picked out the ones with the longest and sharpest thorns, and he put them in a burlap bag. He put some potatoes in the bag on top of them, and some mangoes, oranges, and pineapples. Then he set the bag on his head and carried it up the mountain to where Buki was working in the garden with Jean. "Uncle Buki," Malise said, "your troubles are over. I've found some for you." "Some what for me?" Buki asked a little suspiciously. "Wee-eye," Malise said, putting his load down. "There's plenty of it around if you know where to look for it." "Wah, a present," Buki said, dropping his hoe and grabbing the bag. "What a friend you are." He opened the sack and reached way down in it and picked something out. "Uh-uh, an orange," he said. "That's not wee-eye." He reached again into the bag. "A pineapple," he said. "That's not what the old man was eating." He reached again, deeper than before. "A potato," he said. "That's not it." Then he pushed his hand to the very bottom of the bag, and this time he clutched a cactus leaf. Its sharp thorns went right into Buki's fingers. "Wee-eye," he bellowed as he pulled his hand out. "Wee-eye, it's sticking me." "Hooray," Jean shouted, jumping in the air and clapping his hands. "Hooray, Papa's got his wee-eye." Malise was scampering across the ravine on his way home. "Ay," Buki moaned, licking his hand. "Wait till I get him. I'm wounded. I'm full of cactus needles. My hand's on fire." "What a nice man Malise is," Jean said. "And intelligent, too." Buki just moaned in reply. "Aye," he said, "wee-eye."